This is the time to remember, 'cause it will not last forever. These are the days to hold on to, 'cause we won't, although we'll want to. This is the time, the time is gonna change. I know you gotta move somehow, but I don't wanna lose you now.
Good evening and welcome to Jesus in a Jukebox. We've got a great night planned here. Our topic is time, which is an interesting idea and how it is portrayed at different parts of the Bible. I tell you, one of the things that's really awesome to try to do, and it's part of what put this together, is just do a search on Bible Gateway or something like that for the word time and see how many times it pops up. It's in the 800s, and it's interesting. I went through them all, actually, and to pick out these different themes that are connected with time. So I want to start tonight, as we do each time that we get together for Jesus in a Jukebox, and start with prayer. But this prayer I'm going to take directly from the book of Ephesians. This is a prayer that the Apostle Paul writes to them, and it's one of those instances where time comes up. So if you'll join me in prayer. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. For he chose us in him before the creation of the world to be holy and blameless in his sight. In love, he predestined us for adoption to sonship through Jesus Christ in accordance with his pleasure and will, to the praise of his glorious grace, which he has freely given us in the one he loves. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins in accordance with the riches of God's grace that he lavished on us with all wisdom and understanding. He made known to us the mystery of his will according to his good pleasure, which he purposed in Jesus Christ, to be put into effect when the times reach their fulfillment, to bring unity to all things in heaven and on earth. In him we were also chosen, having been predestined according to the plan of him who works out everything in conformity with the purpose of his will, in order that we who were the first to put our hope in Christ might be for the praise of his glory. And you also were included in Christ when you heard the message of truth, the gospel of your salvation. When you believed, you were marked in him with a seal, the promised Holy Spirit, who is a deposit guaranteeing our inheritance until the redemption of those who are God's possession to praise of his glory. So God, we give you all praise and we give you all thanksgiving. We thank you that you put us in this place and time, and that you have created a place, a space, and a time for us to live. And we give you all thanks for that. Be with all of those who are sick and suffering, all those who are mourning, all those who are grieving, all of those who are seeking you. May they find in this moment the time to turn to peace. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So that first song that I just played a little bit of, it was Billy Joel, This is the Time. And that's really the idea, that this is the time. And it doesn't matter what this is, all times are the time. And I thought that was a good introduction to what we're doing. So I want to give a description of where time comes from, because this is one of those biblical concepts, you know, God's creation, God created time. And so let's look at Genesis 1, verses 14 through 19. And God said, "Let there be lights in the vault of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them serve as signs to mark sacred times and days and years, and let them be lights in the vault of the sky to give light on the earth." And it was so. God made two great lights, the greater light to govern the day and the lesser light to govern the night. He also made the stars. God set them in the vault of the sky to give light on the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate light from darkness. And God saw that it was good, and there was evening and there was morning on the fourth day. And so in that, there is created all things that are time. You know, like we think that time is the numbers on the clock. But really, time is something that we might measure with the tickings of the clock or the days of the year, but it really is a reality in which we live, and that was all set up by God. And so I wanted to try to find a song that would encapsulate this mysteriousness of time. And in the created nature of it, and I, you know, what's more mysterious and beautiful than a song by Enya? And so this is her song, Only Time.
Who can say where the road goes, where the day flows, only and who can say if your love grows as your heart chose, only time. Who can say only time? Who can say why your heart sighs as your love flies, only time. And who can say why your heart cries when your love lies, only time? Who knows, only time? Who knows, only time?
By God. And in that, it's all set up by God. Here's the famous passage from Ecclesiastes 3. There is a time for everything, and a season for every activity under the sun. A time to be born, and a time to die. A time to plant, and a time to uproot. A time to kill, and a time to heal. A time to tear down, and a time to build. A time to weep, and a time to laugh. A time to mourn, and a time to dance. A time to scatter stones and a time to gather them. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to search and a time to give up. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to mend. A time to be silent and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time for war and a time for peace. So in that there's a time for everything under the sun, right? There is a sense that there are times that we see as good and times that we see as bad. And I think we always want to hold on to the good times. So here's a song that tries to capture that difference between and this is Alan Jackson's Good Time. And he makes the difference here between a time of work, which isn't a good time, and a time of play, which seems to be for him a good time. So let's look at this.
Work, work all week long, punching that clock from dusk till dawn. Count the days till Friday night, that's when I know the conditions are right for a good time. Yeah, I need a good time. Yeah, I've been working all week and I'm tired. I don't want to sleep, I want to have fun. I want a good time. Cash my check, clean my truck, put on my hat, forgot about work. Sun going down, head across town, pick up my baby and turn it around for a good time. I need a good time. I've been working all week and I'm tired, I don't want to sleep, I want to have fun. It's time for a good time. It's time for a good time.
Right, and we all know that difference between a good time and a time that, you know, is not. So that's really a great song about that. But one of the things that the Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes also is Ecclesiastes 7:13-14. It says, consider what God has done. Who can straighten what he has made crooked? When times are good, be happy. But when times are bad, consider this. God has made the one as well as the other. Therefore, no one can discover anything about their future. right? If God has made both the good times and the bad times, or the times that we see that way, perhaps there's a peace that can come when we see all of it as God's gift, and that those times at work, if we can see those as important too, and that can keep us from becoming fragmented like so many of us tend to be. But when we are in time, there are aspects of it that are a major challenge to us, right? Like time is what causes us to grow old. Time seems to slow down when we're stuck doing something that we don't want to do. Time starts to speed up when we're doing something that we really love. You know, like it flies when we're having fun. So it seems to be something that is untangible and out of our control. This song, Hootie and the Blowfish's Time, talks about that kind of punishment of time.
Time, why you punish me like a wave crashing into the shore, you wash away my dream. Time, why you walk away like a friend with somewhere to go, you left me crying. Can you teach me about tomorrow and all my pain and sorrow running free? 'Cause tomorrow's just another day and I don't believe in time.
Yeah, and so that song goes on to talk about a lot of different aspects of time that are difficult. I wrote this poem the other day. I was trying to get at, as I was thinking about all these songs of time and all these Bible passages, I was thinking about how many different ways that we use the word time. And so I wrote this. Time is a funny thing, because though each tick of the clock is equal in length, it seems to speed up and slow down. You see, we've got slow time and fast time. We can run out of time, but when something is timeless, it lasts forever. We have bedtime and we hate it when we're children, and can't wait for it when we're adults. Of course, there are meal times, three of those. There's time to get up, there's time to relax, and time to work. We can waste time, we can spend time on others, on projects, even on ourselves. We can save time, but we can't put it in a bottle, because it can be lost. Or at least we can lose track of it. There are good times, bad times, we've all had our share. Hard times too. We can't go back in time, can't turn back time. So there are times we can never get back. Sometimes we treasure, all times we measure. Days, weeks, months, years, hours, minutes, seconds. We call these moments, and they can be precious and magic. They can shine or they can drag on. We can feel trapped in time, but not because time stands still, but because it marches ever onward. Each moment matters, so we can seize the day. You can stop to smell the roses, but you can't stop time. Times change, and they are a-changing, always, at all times. But you, our Lord, who made time, exist out of time, eternal. But your name is a time marker, is, now, but also forever. It's I am. Yes, you are. And you would even enter time at just the right time, to show us there is more than time. That though we stand shackled inside the ticking clock, we can shuffle off this mortal coil and join you like you did us, beyond time, forever. So here is Ain't It Funny How Time Slips Away. Well, hello there. It's been a long, long time. Well, hello there. It's been a long, long time. How am I doing? I guess that I'm doing fine. It's been so long now, it seems like it's only been yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? How's your new love? I hope that he's doing fine. I heard you told him that you'd love him till the end of time. Well, that's the same thing that you told me, it seems like yesterday. Ain't it funny how time slips away? I'm gonna go now, I guess I'll see you around. But I don't know when, though I don't know how. But I remember what I tell you. In time you're gonna pay. Ain't it funny how time slips away? So in time we feel like there's a lot of it, and you know it's this weird thing where, like I said before in the poem, it was that time moves fast, it also moves slow. Sometimes it seems like we have all the time in the world and that we can just waste it. And that's where these next couple of songs come in, this idea of taking time, and in this one, killing time, and in another one, wasting time. This is Clint Black's Killing Time. You were the first thing that I thought of when I thought I drank. When I get lost in the liquor, you're the only one I'll find. If I did the things I ought to, you still would not be mine. So I keep a tight grip on the bottle, getting loose, killing time. But this killing time is killing. Drinking myself blind, hoping I won't see that if I cross that line and they bury me, that I just might find I'll be killing time for eternity. It's a good old country song, right? But it has the warning, right? The fact that if you're doing these things to waste time, how do you get out of it? How do you put that off? It's easy to fall into those pits, right? And Romans 13, 1:11-12 kind of speaks to this. And do this, understanding the present time. The hour has already come for you to wake up from your slumber. Because our salvation is nearer now than when we first believe. The night is nearly over. The day is almost here. So let us put aside the deeds of darkness and put on the armor of light. That there's more to be done than just simply killing time to to find something in the future. This song is about a similar idea, not necessarily killing time, but this time wasting time. Yeah, I'm just a waste of her energy. She's just wasting my time. So why don't we get together and we could waste everything tonight. We could waste it all. But everybody thinks that everybody knows about everybody else. Nobody knows anything about themselves, 'cause they're all worried about somebody else. Love's just a waste of our energy. This life's just a waste of our time. So why don't we get together? We could waste everything tonight. Yeah, we could waste it all. But everybody thinks that everybody knows about everybody else. Nobody knows anything about themselves, 'cause they're all worried about somebody else. I found this, Psalm 39, verses 4 to 5. Show me, Lord, my life's end and the number of my days. Let me know how fleeting my life is. You have made my days a mere handbreadth. The span of my years is as nothing before you. Everyone is but a breath, even those who seem secure. If we could see how precious life is and how fleeting, perhaps it would give us more of an emphasis on trying to not waste our time that we've been given. But then there's the question about what is it that we're supposed to be doing, and when and how. This song, I told you this is going to be a night of a kind of eclectic, a bunch of different songs. This one, Pink Floyd, Time, gets at that question about nobody ever tells you when it's time and what when that was supposed to do, and you can find that that you missed that opportunity. And so that's kind of what this song is about. Fretting and waste the hour and all.
And you run and you run to catch up with the sun, but it's sinking. And racing around to come up behind you again. The sun is the same in a relative way, but you're older. Shorter. Time is gone, the song is over. Thought that I'd have more to say.
That's right, that's a song about having missed time, having waste time. You look back and you've lost it, right? Look at this. This is from Ecclesiastes. This is more wisdom. Ecclesiastes 11, 4 through 6. Whoever watches the wind will not plant. Whoever looks at the clouds will not reap. As you do not know the path of the wind or how the body is formed in a mother's womb, so you cannot understand the work of God, the maker of all things. Sow your seed in the morning, and at evening let your hands not be idle. For you do not know which will succeed, whether this or that, or whether both will do equally well. Right? There's that gets us. We could spend so much time, and the philosophers in us, you know, we spend so much time wondering what it is that we should do, that we miss the opportunity to actually do something. So that comes out in that song really, really well. I'm going to shift now. One of the great themes in the Bible is the steadfast nature of God, that though our times get hard and troubled and that we go astray, that God's very steadfast in his love for us. Nehemiah chapter 9, verses 25 to 28 read like this. They captured fortified cities and fertile land. They took possession of houses filled with all kinds of good things. Wells already dug, vineyards, olive groves, and fruit trees in abundance. They ate to the full and were well nourished. They reveled in your great goodness. But they were disobedient and rebelled against you. They turned their backs on your law. They killed your prophets who had warned them in order to turn them back to you. They committed awful blasphemies. So you delivered them into the hands of their enemies who oppressed them. But when they were oppressed, they cried out to you from heaven, and you heard them. In your great compassion, you gave them deliverers who rescued them from the hands of their enemies. But as soon as they were at rest, they again did what was evil in your sight. And then you abandoned them to a hand of their enemies so that they ruled over them. And when they cried out to you again, you heard from heaven, and in your compassion, you delivered them time after time. And it's that line, time after time, that I'm going to bring out in this song. This song's Time After Time by Cyndi Lauper. It's a staple of mine when I was playing back in the old days, because it was kind of a strange thing for me to sing. But it gets at that idea of this is somebody saying that no matter what happens, I will be there again and again, time after time. And so here.
Lying in bed, I hear the clock tick and think of you. Caught up in circles, confusion is nothing new. Flashbacks, warm nights, almost left behind. Suitcase memories, time. Sometimes you picture me, I'm walking too far ahead.
You're calling to me. I can't hear what you said. Then you say, go slow. I fall behind. The second hand unwinds. If you're lost, you can look. You will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you. I'll be waiting. Time after time. If you're lost, you can look and you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you. I'll be waiting. Time after time. After my picture fades in darkness, it's turned to gray. Watching through windows, you're wondering if I'm okay. Secrets stolen from deep inside. The drum beats out of time. If you're lost, you can look, you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you. I fall behind. The second hand unwinds. If you're lost, you can look. You will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you. I'll be waiting. Time after time. If you're lost, you can look. And you will find me. Time after time. If you fall, I will catch you. I will be waiting. Time after time. Time after time. Time after time. Time after time. So we see God giving us that kind of forgiveness, that time after time, every time that we mess up, it doesn't matter, that he'll always be with us. But we wonder if we could give others that same kind of forgiveness, right? Peter asked Jesus how many times they should forgive their brothers or sisters. And in Matthew 18, this is 18, 21 through 22. Then Peter came to Jesus and asked, Lord, how many times shall I give my brother or sister who sins against me? Up to seven times? Jesus answered, I tell you, not seven times, but 77 times. Jesus tells us to continue to forgive, but it's hard for us, right? We like to draw lines in the sand. This song is called This Time by Waylon Jennings. This time, if you want me to come back, it's up to you. But remember, I won't allow the things you used to do. You're gonna have to toe the mark and walk the line. Cause this time will be the last time. Well, this time, if I should feel unwanted, I won't stay. Each tomorrow will depend on the love you give today. It's all up to you, but keep in mind, this time will be the last time. This time will be the last time. This time should be anything like those other times. This time will be the last time. This time should be anything like any other of those times. Oh, this time will be the last.
last time. Oh, this time will be the last time. This time will be the last time. This time.
Right, this time. How many times? 77 times. No, we tend to like the reckoning day where things are put right. This is you know you'd hear these words in Jeremiah like 50:30-31. Therefore, her young men will fall in the streets; all her soldiers will be silenced in that day, declares the Lord. See, I am against you, you arrogant one, declares the Lord Almighty. For your day has come, the time for you to be punished. Right there, it seems like there is a reckoning, and it's even in that other verse, right? There's a sense that there's a punishment and then the lesson is learned, and so then there's a forgiveness. There seems to be a pattern. It happens again and again, but yet it doesn't mean that there is never that reckoning. So this is Led Zeppelin, Your Time Is Gonna Come. Led Zeppelin justice, but there's something right that notion of your time is gonna come. It's gonna happen. It's gonna catch up to you. Ezekiel 7:6-8. The end has come. The end has come. It has roused itself against you. See, it comes. Doom has come upon you who dwell in the land. The time has come. The day is near. There's a panic, not joy, on the mountains. I'm about to pour out my wrath on you and spend my anger against you. I will judge you according to your conduct and repay you for all of your detestable practices. That is one of the ideas that we are that we have in time is that there is a time when things will happen and change. And if justice doesn't exist now, there is a time when things are going to be set right. It's interesting to think about this paralleled or juxtaposed with the idea of God being timeless. And how does he see these things that we see maybe in a different way? And then the other question is when, you know, like when. And when we're stuck in time, we wonder, when will these things change? When will the time come when things are set right? But Matthew 24, 36 through 44 says this: "But about that day or hour, no one knows, not even the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. As it was in the days of Noah, so it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. For in the days before the flood, people were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage up to the day Noah entered the ark. And they knew nothing about what would happen until the flood came and took them all away. That is how it will be at the coming of the Son of Man. Two men will be in the field, one will be taken and the other left. Two women will be grinding with a handmill, one will be taken and the other left. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know on what day your Lord will come. But understand this: if the owner of the house had known at what time of night the thief was coming, he would have kept watch and would not have let his house be broken into. So you also must be ready, because the Son of Man will come at an hour when you do not expect him." Right? This notion of timelessness means that things could happen at any time, and that to be constantly ready and constantly vigilant. This is the times they are a-changing.
Come gather around, people, wherever you roam, and admit that the waters around you have grown, and accept it that soon you'll be drenched to the bone. If your time to you is worth saving, but you better start swimming or you'll sink like a stone, for the times, they are a-changing. Come writers and critics who prophesy with your pen, keep your eyes wide, the chance won't come again. Don't speak too soon, for the wheel's still in spin, and there's no telling who that it's naming. For the loser now will be later to win, for the times, they are a-changing. Come senators, congressmen, please heed the call. Don't stand in the doorway, don't block up the hall, for he that gets hurt will be he who is stalled. There's a battle outside that is raging. It'll shake your windows and rattle your walls, for the times, they are a-changing. Come mothers and fathers throughout the land, and don't criticize what you can't understand. Your sons and your daughters are beyond your command. Well, your old road is rapidly aging. Please get out of the new one if you can lend a hand, for the times, they are a-changing. The line it is drawn, the curse it is cast, the slow one now will be later fast, as the present now will later be past. The older is rapidly fading, the first one will now be later the last, for the times, they are a-changing.
Some songs are timeless because some things are timeless, right? This the sense of the change of time, changing things throughout. But it's interesting because Jesus talks about this, right? And the fact that we don't always recognize it. He said to the crowd, "When you see a cloud rising in the west, immediately you say it's going to rain, and it does. And when the south wind blows, you say it's going to be hot, and it is. Hypocrites. You know how to interpret the appearance of the earth and the sky. How is it that you do not know how to interpret this present time? That's so very true, all of us. We have our eyes to the past, our eyes to the future. We seem to miss the present time, and we often do. But look at how Jeremiah points at the same thing. I have listened intently, but they do not say what is right. None of them repent of their wickedness, saying, what have I done? Each pursues their own course, like a horse charging into battle. Even the stork in the sky knows her appointed seasons, and the dove, the swift, and the thrush observe the time of their migration. But my people do not know the requirements of the Lord. How can you say we are wise, for we have the law of the Lord, when actually the lying pen of the scribes has handled it falsely? I think the times that we are in now, these times of this coronavirus and whatever else, has shown how little people, those so-called experts and whatever else, truly know about the way that the world works, right? This song is called Times Like These. Times like these, times like those, what will be, and so it goes on and on. There's always been laughing, crying, birth and dying. Boys and girls are wild, are sticking, giving, breaking, healing, growing, recreating, nurture from hurting times like these. Times like those, what will be, and so it goes. Right? Times like these, times like those, they always are. And rarely do we have the ability to judge them in the moment. I want to shift now to times of trouble. I found in that Bible search that I was doing how many times the words times of trouble come up. And it's always that in the context of the Lord is my stronghold in times of trouble. But times of trouble are always around us, but sometimes worse than others. This song is called Times of Trouble, and it's pretty dark, I'm going to warn you. But there's some great lines in it. It's like, don't try to do it, don't try to kill your time. Like, it's about suicide, right? Don't try to do it, don't try to kill your time. You might do it, then you can, but you can't change your mind, right? Like, there's certain things that we can do that but you've got to hold on to your time till you break through the times of trouble. Obviously, this song is someone that doesn't necessarily have faith, or they've lost all their faith. What a blessing it is to be able to give our pain and to put our trust in the Lord during the times of trouble. So let me play a little bit of this.
Don't try to do it, Don't try to kill your time. Then you can't change your mind. You gotta hold on to your time. Break through these times of trouble. Through these times of trouble. When you try. And the words get hard, and they put you down. Don't you stay? Don't you ditch away? I saw you swinging. Swinging your mother's song. I know you're playing, but sometimes the rules get hard. But somebody put you out on that ledge. If somebody pushed you over the edge, you gotta hold on to your time till you break. Through these times of trouble, these times of trouble.
To break through the times of trouble. Psalm 9, 8 through 10. He rules the world in righteousness and judges the people with equity. The Lord is a refuge for the oppressed and a stronghold in times of trouble. Psalm 10. Why, Lord, do you stand far off? Why do you hide yourself in times of trouble? But then in the beginning of 1 Samuel, in her deep anguish, Hannah prayed to the Lord, weeping bitterly. And she made a vow, saying, Lord Almighty, if you will look upon your servant's mystery and remember me, and not forget your servant, but give her a son, then I will give him to the Lord for all the days of his life, and no razor will ever be used on his head. She kept praying to the Lord, and Eli observed her mouth. Hannah was praying in her heart, and her lips were moving, but her voice was not heard. Early the next morning, they arose and worshiped before the Lord, and then went back to their home at Ramah. Elkanah made love to his wife Hannah, and the Lord remembered her. So in the course of time, Hannah became pregnant and gave birth to a son. She named him Samuel, saying, because I have asked the Lord for him. There is a hope in these present times of trouble, always in the Lord. We see the patterns of life, and we see those patterns repeating themselves. It happens again and again. We could get the notion that we're kind of like powerless in this wave. Ecclesiastes 9:1-9-10 says, what has been will be again. What has been done will be done again. There is nothing new under the sun. Is there anything of which one can say, look, this is something new? It was here already long ago. It was here before our time. You can get this illusion that time is on your side, that we have lots of time left. That's one way to see this pattern. But I'm going to play. Yes, it is. Time is on my side. Yes, it is. Now you always say that you want to be free, but you
reaching for good times, but just wait and see, 'cause you'll come running back. Yes, you will, baby, you'll come running back.
We can get this illusion, right, that in this midst of the time, since the time's out of control, we can almost feel like we can have our own, that we're in control, right? It's this weirdest thing that only works in time, is that it seems like, well, you know, if we look at the full pattern, God will forgive us. We might as well, you know, live how we want, knowing that the forgiveness will come around. But that's really kind of missing something, because it puts us in control of time, and we're not in control of time. And not being in control of time can lead us to the thinking that we are, right? Like, think about Job, in the great times where God is answering Job's question, and at the end, this part is in 38, 22 to 24. Have you entered the storehouses of the snow, or the storehouse of the hail, which I reserve for times of trouble, for days of war or battle? What is the way to the place where the lightning is dispersed, or the place where the east winds are scattered over the earth? Right? We forget that God is very much the one that's in control. And if we thought we were in control, we might be able to control time for ourselves. And this song is a really sweet, beautiful one, asking that question: if I could save time in a bottle, if I were the one that were able to relive things, and we're constantly trying to, you know, science fiction is full of the idea of trying to control time or to go back in time. Here it is. It's somewhere in our desires, living in time, to be able to capture it and hold on to it. If I could save time in a bottle, the first thing that I'd like to do is to save every day till eternity passes away, just to spend them with you. If I could make days last forever, if words could make wishes come true, I'd save every day like a treasure, and then again I would spend them with you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things you want to do once you find. I looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go through time with. If I had a box just for wishes and dreams that had never come true, the box would be empty except for the memory of how they were answered by you. But there never seems to be enough time to do the things I want to do once you find them. I looked around enough to know you're the one I want to go through time with. Job goes on to, in this, that same chapter 38, this is verse starting at verse 31. Can you bind the chains of the Pleiades? Can you loosen Orion's belt? Can you bring forth the constellations in their seasons, or lead out the bear with its cubs? Do you know the laws of the heavens? Can you set up God's dominion over the earth? Right? Remaining humble in time is important. All of those things, the Pleiades, the Orion's belt, they're talking about the stars, right? And back in Genesis 1 that we read earlier, the stars were put in place to mark time and special occasions. Psalm 31 puts it this way, verses 14 and 15. But I trust in you, Lord. I say, you are my God. My times are in your hands. Deliver me from the hands of my enemies, from those who pursue me. And there's a great wisdom in that. There's great peace in that. Saying to God, my times are in your hands. I was trying to look at a song to kind of capture what we would hope for in time. It's like the idea of holding on to a moment, giving your times over to God and allowing those times to be. But at the same time, having that time be the greatest time that it could possibly be, that with you perfectly in the moment, made for these times. If God truly created us and created us in his image and put all of this in motion, then the notion that we are made for the times that we're in and that we can have these moments where we are perfect and feel full in the times that we have. You know, it takes all that humility that we've talked about up to this point. But there's that prayer. Can I be right for this time? And I don't think any song captures this quite like Whitney Houston's One Moment in Time. So I'm going to sing a little bit of that. Each day I live, I want to be a day to give the best of me. I'm only one, but not alone. The finest day is yet unknown. I broke my heart for every gain to taste the sweet. I face the pain. I rise and fall, yet through it all, this much remains. Give me one moment in time when I'm racing with destiny, and then in that one moment in time, I will feel eternity. How beautiful is that? To feel eternity, right? That's that grace moment. That one escape from time. The moment. Living in the moment is the way to escape time. It's interesting that God is the God whose very name means is. Whose very name means is, and therefore is alive in every moment. Every single moment. For us to see that way, that, you know, that this entire, the entire Bible, the entire idea of this night, the entire deal of songs or feelings of truth about time being fast and slow, and that all of time is encapsulated in each and every moment, the entire story of the fall and grace, and this and the chance for redemption is there in every single moment. Isaiah 26, 3 and 4, you will keep in perfect peace those whose minds are steadfast because they trust in you. Trust in the Lord forever, for the Lord himself is the rock eternal. The rock eternal, whose name is I Am. Mark 1, verses 14 and 15, after John was put in prison, Jesus went to Galilee proclaiming the good news of God. The time has come, he said. The kingdom of God has come near. Repent and believe the good news. This moment. It's at a time where it could have been the worst moment, right? That John has been taken to prison. It's at that moment Jesus is proclaiming, that the kingdom of God is near. It's the same as when the temple is destroyed in Jerusalem. The time of the Lord is now. It's the same when Jesus is hung on the cross and they try to put him in the stone. The time of the Lord is now. So I'm going to leave you with this prayer of benediction. That we give all thanks to God for this evening, and we thank him for the chance to think and to study time, to think about how much each moment matters and how his life, his presence in our lives is what it is all about. Let this scriptural passage be the benediction. Hosea 10, verse 12. Sow righteousness for yourself, reap the fruit of unfailing love, and break up your unplowed ground. For it is time to seek the Lord until he comes and showers his righteousness on you. May he shower that righteousness on you in this moment, and may you feel that in every moment. God bless. Thank you so much for being with us for Jesus in the Jukebox. Amen.